hotels. Most people think all bees live in hives, but most of them actually live alone. They are called solitary bees. Some solitary bees in Arizona are leafcutter bees, mason bees, and carpenter bees. Many species of bees are becoming endangered or extinct, and one of the largest threats is habitat loss. Luckily, there's something we can do to help. Bee hotels are man-made structures that mimic the homes that bees would normally live in the wild. Plus, they're super easy to make. First, acquire some wood. Most people use hollow bamboo tubes, but my dad and I made our own tools. There should be a variety of different size holes for the bees to choose from. Also, there should only be one opening for each tube. Many people use clay to plug up the bag. Next, put all of the tubes together tightly. Some people put them in flower pots or coffee mugs. Other people even make their own structures. We used twine for ours. Make sure to place your bee hotel somewhere against a flat surface. It should be off the ground, but not too high. It should also be in a spot that catches some high light, and preferably facing south or southwest, where the sun can keep the bees warm and healthy. We mounted ours to a wall to make it look a little more natural. In addition, the bee hotel should be in an area with enough plants and flowers for the bees to eat. We put ours in a garden. You will know if your bee hotel is in use when you see bees going in and out, or if you see the holes covered in mud. Like people, bees like privacy, and the mud is their home. Here's a link if you're interested. Thank you so much for watching my video.